also to our fifth and final quarter final from the Yonex-Sunrise India Open. It is women's doubles. It's the defending champions, Miyuki Maeda and Satoko S.Suetsuna of Japan, up against the home favourites, Jwala J.Gutta and Ashwini A.Ponnappa. There, the left-handed, tall left-handed Jwala J.Gutta. Well, she's been in three finals here at the Indian Open. Won one of them. Mixed doubles winner 2 years ago. Well, that was before it was a Super Series event. Now, of course, part of the OSIN BWF World Super Series. 12 tournaments each year make up the Super Series. So a year ago, the Japanese pair were the number one seeds. The number two seeds, their teammates Fuji and Kakiwa, in the final a year ago. Two games which lasted an hour and 10 minutes. For Jwala J.Gutta and her partner Ashwini A.Ponnappa, this stadium will evoke very happy memories for them, because this is exactly where they won their one and only title, and it was the Commonwealth Games gold medal. Not seeded here, 20 in the world ranking. They have been as high as 13. Six tournaments, individual tournaments, they've played this year. Of course, they've played Yuba Cup qualifying as well, which is why they've had more losses in the six individual tournaments that they've played. So the Japanese pair, there, Satoko S.Suetsuna, 31 years of age, and her partner Maeda, she's 26. Positive win-loss record for the year. Seeded 3, world ranking of 6, second Japanese pair in the world ranking. And as it stands at the moment, it would mean that they would definitely qualify for the Olympic Games. 7 tournaments this year, 7 individual tournaments. Best previously a semi-final in the Australian Grand Prix, where incidentally they were the number one seeds. So this the fifth meeting between these two pairs, but I guess the most important one was the last meeting. But it has to be said that that was in the last 16 of the 2010 Singapore Open, Singapore Super Series event, so haven't played each other for almost 2 years. There,
ready to play.
On the right, as we look at them, Pulela Gopichand,
Mida,
head coach,
Jwala, ready
the
to
Indian
play.
Team, sitting alongside him is Edwin Indarawan of Indonesia, and there the Japanese coaching bench.
Mida and Suetsuna, ready to play.
Well, I can tell you that the Japanese pair, 3 games in their second round match against the Southeast Asian Games gold medalists, Augustin and Nafiswari of Indonesia. And for Jwala J.Gutta and Ashwini A.Ponnappa, they too had to go the full distance yesterday. Got revenge for the defeat last week in Qingdao at the Asian Championships when they beat Vita Marissa and Nadia Melati of Indonesia. Incidentally, they were 3-9 down in the third game and 11-14 down. court officials.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the right, Miyuki Mida and Satoko Suetsuna, Japan. And on the left, Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa, India. Jwala to serve to Miyuki Mida. Love all, split.
So, the unseeded Indian pairing. And Commonwealth Games gold medalist Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa. Left and right-handed combination up against the defending champions Miyuki M.Maeda and Satoko S.Suetsuna.
One love.
These two pairs were both bronze medalists from last year's World Championships. In the previous four meetings that these two pairs have had against each other, all occasions have gone the full distance, always gone to three games. And I just can't help but wonder, perhaps with the home support, whether that it may
two.
Help the Indian pairing. Notice Jwala Gutta was giving an interview earlier in the week, and she was saying, well, some players find playing at home extra pressure. She enjoys it. Good swimmer when she was younger, and then decided to concentrate her time and effort on badminton. A good powerful smash, good placement. Aiming towards the right shoulder of S.Suetsuna. Time the smash.
Service over. 5-2.
Just indicating to the service judge, wants him to keep an eye on that serve, felt it was coming a bit high.
Four, six.
Yes, they do look so much more impressive when they're on the attack, the Indian combination. Well, that's a good interception by M.Maeda, and I have to say, I think that her women's doubles has benefited considerably since she's been playing mixed doubles on the tour as well. Far more adventurous at the front of the court. Good judgment, lets it drop long. Right idea. Trying to block the defensive shot.
Eight,
if you block, turn
six,
the shuttle or drive it back, then there's an opportunity for you to turn your defensive play into attacking play. More than just lifting and giving your opponents more opportunities to hit in a downward direction.
Nine, six.
Very clever placement of the smash.
Seven, nine.
Affecting the Indian pairing.
Seven.
Channel attack down the center, confusing the two Indian players who should take the defensive shot, and they're deep in conversation. Oh, just sorting that out. Crowd really trying to get behind J.Gutta and A.Ponnappa. Another dispute amongst the players as to whether the shuffle should be changed or not. Umpire having to make the decision. That's a good smash.
Nine,
not the tallest of athletes. Very slender frame as well. But my goodness, you can pack a punch with that smash. Again.
Jim all.
Once again, there's a dispute about the shuttle. Very much the commander of the partnership, J.Gutta. Defending champions
11-10 in
Jwala. Have the advantage at the mid-game interval, but it could not be closer. Pramila Gopichand, winner of the All England Championships in 2001, and of course has an academy, Badminton Academy, where all the
Court one,
national team seconds. Train in Hyderabad.
Court one, 20 seconds.
Interesting that Ashwini Ponnappa actually started her badminton career at the Prakash Academy. In Bangalore, of course, his academy, Prakash Patakoni.
Levin, Chan, play. Service fault called.
Service fault called, struck above the waist.
Service over.
S.Suetsuna. Not too pleased by that.
All.
Understandably so. No player likes to be called a fault on their serve.
Service over. 12, 11.
The serve is short, and both the Japanese players at the moment are struggling serving wise. Well, for the first time in the match, Indian pairing go into the lead. Defended so well for so long. She was right to try and play the block. Having lifted and lifted again. Yeah, there was the gap across court there. It was the right idea. Straight smash and follows forward. Here we go, straight down the line. That's the one.
Serve is over. 14 all.
No, she's pushing it wide.
15, 14.
Japanese pair now back in front. What a good return of serve from Jwala Gutta.
15, all. Out.
Oh, my goodness, mate.
16, 15.
Oh, that's clever. Wonderful vision from Ashwini Ponnappa. Yes, absolutely tremendous. When they're on the attack like that, the Commonwealth Games gold medalist.
18, 16.
Good serve. Oh, the crowd absolutely loving this little run of points. Four straight points to be precise. Opportunities. Oh, dear me.
So it's over. 17, 20.
I know they just rushed to serve a little bit. That's a good shot from S.Suetsuna.
18, 20. Thank you.
Sorale. Well, that's where she's improved so much, by playing mixed doubles. Miyuki M.Maeda. Well, three game points have been saved. Just one more game point opportunity for Gutta and Ponnappa. This time with an excellent return of serve.
First game won by Jwala Gutta, Ashwini Ponnappa, 21-19
in 20 minutes of play. And the fans here delight in that. So there's just confirmation that the Commonwealth Games gold medalists, the home players, Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa, taking that excellent opening game. Tough battle, 21-19. Well, we thought this would be a close one. These two pairs, of course, bronze medalists from last year's World Championships in Wembley, which of course is where the Olympic competition will take place later this year. And talking of Olympics, Indian pair at 20 in the world rankings, on the absolute cusp of qualifying for those Olympic Games. Now, by my calculations, there are seven pairs ranked above them that are not eligible to qualify for the Olympics, because of course you're only allowed a maximum of two pairs per nation, and those two pairs must be both ranked in the top eight in the world, and therefore seven pairs that won't be able to qualify because of those rules. And yet there's also a rule that says that every continent, all five continents, must have a representation if those pairs are ranked in the top 50 in the world. And I can tell you that the Pan-American pair are ranked at 28, the Australian pair from Oceania at 35, and the African pair at 44. So those three continental representations will take place. Of course, Europe and Asia are already represented, which of course means that, I think by my calculations, that Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa will get in the Olympic Games by the skin of their teeth. Certainly, a victory here to take them through to the semi-final would help their cause.
Three, two.
A clever block, clever net shot from Jwala Gutta.
Three,
Yeah, that was the one. Force the lift. And the lift was long. There's a few players, top players nowadays, that still uses the forehand serve. Jwala Gutta, and very effective it is too.
Serve is over. 4-3.
Player is M.Maeda. Nice to see her being so expressive of her joy when she wins a rally. Indian combination have placed their attacking shots so well today, and they've varied the pace nicely as well, but their smashes have been particularly impressive.
So
it's a nice drop shot.
6-4.
Just long of the back line. Right idea to try and be aggressive on the defence. Signs to me that the defending champions from Japan have decided that they really have to take more initiative within the rallies, using more attacking play themselves than they did in the opening game. S.Suetsuna didn't want to change the shuttle. The umpire agrees with the Indian pair that shuttle may be a little bit distorted.
Goes over.
Indian combination looking a very complete pair nowadays. Used to be the case that they really did have their favoured formation. I think they still prefer it when the left-handed Jwala Gutta goes forward to the net. She's an excellent mixed doubles player and her reading of the game at the front of the court is superb. And I don't think they have the same sort of rigid formation. They're far more fluent in their movement. Oh, that's a clever smash.
Serves over. 11-6 interval.
Five-point advantage.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Just to remind you, of course, that all four previous meetings have gone the full distance, gone to three games. And I have to say, it's looking at the moment as if history will probably repeat itself.
11-6. Flip.
What am I talking about? Servers out. Well, took the initiative, took the chance.
Seven.
And the courage to do that paid dividends. Very few players in world badminton would have had the courage to step forward when the shuttle had been lifted. And Jwala Gutta knew that it was going to come back to the net area. And she knew that her reactions were quick enough to deal with it.
8-11 play.
Well, mind games going on here because Jwala Gutta been made to wait while M.Maeda went to the side of the court and mopped her brow. Seeing she was back on court, then Jwala Gutta did exactly the same thing, made her wait. Oh, that's well, so well along with the back line.
12-8.
Oh, the luck of the net cord there for M.Maeda.
There's
a little squeal of delight from the Japanese pair every time they win a rally. Body of Jwala Gutta, forcing the eye.
16-9.
Well, a 7-point advantage now. And I suspect we're heading to a decider. Long. Another smash, not brought down steeply enough. Just lost the momentum at the moment. Indian pair. And the crowd has fallen rather silent.
Goes over. Jim. 18.
Once again, the Japanese pair asked that the shuttle be changed, and Jwala Gutta says no. There's going to be a discussion about this. Shuttle changed, and once again, Jwala Gutta says no. From wide. Discussions. Finally, the umpire agrees with the Japanese pair.
Look.
Oh, that's a good return of serve.
Goes over 19-12.
2 points away from this second game.
Game point, drop.
8 opportunities to make it one game apiece.
Goes over.
Second time of asking, and the second game
won by Miyuki M.Maeda
goes to
Satoko,
the defending champions.
21-13.
One game all. Confirms the umpire. 39 minutes, and we're one apiece. So one game apiece in this women's doubles quarterfinal. The two bronze medal winning pairs from the World Championships last year battling it out. And as one would suspect of the status of bronze medalists, a very close affair.
Jwala. Final game. Low wall. Flip.
Well, as so often, I think the start to this deciding game, the first half dozen rallies or so, could be absolutely crucial. Sets the tone for the whole game. Of patience in the end. Ashwini A.Ponnappa. Say that, should I? Every time I say that, then the rally ends with an error rather than a winning shot. I think for the home pair that they've got to stop this run and stop it right now. Now unable to do so.
Five love
lead. The difference in body language between the two pairs at the moment, quite stark. Slight delay because the court attendants needed to come on and mop up.
One fight flat.
Good serve. Yes, and the high lift is long of that back line.
Five.
got to take into account the drift in this arena. Clever smash from M.Maeda. Once again, six, switching two. From making Gutta defend from her favoured backhand side to try and defend forehand.
Service fault called. Service over.
Service fault called once again. Struck above the waist.
Three, six.
Well, the psychological battles going on between these two pairs. Change the shuttle? No, don't want to. Battle of wills. Not just skills. That's long of the back line.
Four, six.
Well, I think she's right to try and be aggressive on the defensive play.
7-4.
Making the error on that occasion. She doesn't miss many of those. No wonder she's disappointed. Making opponents wait, their mind games continue. Bonapur was perhaps four. Expecting Jwala Gutta to have intercepted that one. Absolutely imperative, I think, for the home pair that they at least close the gap a little before the change of ends. Yeah, well worked by the Japanese
Seven
pair,
four.
Greeted
Into
with almost silence from the home fans. Well, a 7-point advantage to the defending champions. And just not able to penetrate with their attacking play as they did in the opening game. Yes, very involved in the discussions, Jwala Gutta.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Coach, thank you. On the court. Eleven, four. Flip.
Still, the discussions continue with the Indian pairing. Well, the court is mopped.
Clap.
Oh, it's a good return. Deep into the backhand corner.
5-11.
What a shot. Well, I don't know what Pilela Gopichan said to his pair. Well, whatever he said, it's worked. Oh, it's landed in misjudgment. She could have played it.
12-6.
There's a real swing in the step now of the Japanese combination. A gap in between the two Indian players, but she found it.
Yes, it's six.
Good positive play now by the defending champions. They were a little bit negative, a little bit defensive in the opening game. Good flick serve. Oh!
Goes over.
Well, the luck of the net cord there from 15. Ashwini Ponnappa. Desperation defence. In all sorts of trouble. Shuttle hit the top of the tape. Trickled over. That's the one, the change of pace.
9-15.
That's a well-worked rally. We're having discussions after every single rally now about whether the shuttle should be changed. The crowd here in Delhi really trying to lift the home players now. Four straight points and all of a sudden the 5-point deficit is believable that it can be closed. Now make that 4-point deficit.
11-15.
9 points adrift just a moment ago. How quickly things can change. Oh, it's so fraction wide. The Japanese pair very quick to ask for a towel down. I'm slightly surprised that the umpire allowed it.
Quick.
And the umpire now trying to hurry them back onto court. Yeah, really taking their time. Flip. Oh, that's great vision. See the gap. Drive the shuttle into the open space. Well, Japanese pair saying that the shuttle was short, umpire calling it as good, and now there's only 3 points in it. Oh, the flick serve is long.
Service over.
Didn't take into account the drift.
17-13.
Well, they weathered the storm because they were in all sorts of trouble early in that rally. Japanese pair well to dig themselves out of trouble. Now just 3 points away, the number three seeds from securing their place in the semi-final. Confusion in the camp. J.Gutta was looking to move forward. Ponnappa hadn't moved out. Oh, what a great flick serve. And now
20,
seven
match point
opportunities. Calmly left.
Comes over. 14, 20.
And this time, the defending champions convert and secure the victory and break the hearts of the home fans. And because India's Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa defeated here at the quarter-final stage. This was how it ended. And the victory, 19-21, 21-13, 21-14 in the deciding game, an hour and 3 minutes. Well, it was an excellent women's doubles. And good to see the defending champions in the deciding game being a little more proactive and a little more aggressive in their style. Confirmation of the score of that women's doubles, which of course concludes our quarterfinal action for this afternoon. It all started with an upset in the men's singles, and Peter Gaydup, last year's beaten finalist, losing to Song Wan Ho. Then an upset also in the men's doubles, with Tu and Tan being beaten by Pratama and Saputra. And then Sukit and Sara Lee overcoming the Malaysians in the mixed doubles. Of course, Malaysia will feature tomorrow in semi-finals with Lee Chong Wei. Well, we will be back tomorrow with semi-final action, 1400 local time. That's 0830 GMT. Hope you'll join us tomorrow for semi-finals. In the meantime, from all of us here in Delhi, bye for now.